Microtubules are large polymers with many essential functions, from maintaining the structure of the cell to separating duplicated chromosomes during mitosis. For these various functions, microtubules are highly regulated, both in their initial formation, known as nucleation, and in the elongation and shrinkage of existing microtubules. The microtubule is made up of protein dimers of alpha and beta tubulin. These dimers interact laterally and longitudinally to form the 13-member tube of the microtubule. One complex that is crucial for microtubule nucleation is the gamma-tubulin ring complex. This is the complex that anchors microtubules to the microtubule organizing center of the cell. The gamma-tubulin ring complex functions as a template. It presents a 13-member gamma-tubulin ring onto which tubulin dimers assemble laterally. Interestingly, gamma-tubulin itself forms laterally associated arrays, even in the absence of other proteins. We used these arrays to study the nucleation ability of gamma-tubulin alone. Another protein of interest, XMAP215, greatly increases the elongation rate of existing microtubules. But XMAP215 has been implicated in nucleation as well. To measure nucleation, we use the classical light scattering assay. This assay monitors the assembly of tubulin dimers into polymers that are large enough to scatter light. We made XMAP215 constructs that differed in their ability to elongate. We found they also differed in their ability to nucleate, and that these two abilities correlated closely. We also found that XMAP215 and gamma tubulin work together to promote nucleation, and that their combined effect is additive. Our work clarifies how microtubules are generated in the cell. We propose that gamma tubulin promotes the first lateral interactions of tubulin dimers, and that XMAP215 adds tubulin dimers only later in nucleation.